Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about 4-bit ring counter and its order code is 38521. So in this video we are going to discuss how it works.
So this is a 4-bit ring counter. Here we are having 4 7476 ICs. So these are the 4 7476 ICs and the pin configuration is also shown here. So we are having the output ports here and we have to connect the supply here and the ground here and the clock and the clear ports, and similarly we can do the ring counter function. So for this module we required a main unit.
Now we are going to perform the experiment of 4-bit ring counter. So for that we are using this main unit, which is digital trainer, and its order code is 33504. So we will use this digital trainer to perform the 4-bit ring counter operation. So firstly we have to do the connections. So firstly we will connect the plus 5 volt supply from the main unit to the module like this, and now we will connect the ground from the main unit to the module like this, and now we will connect the clock with one of the two pulsers. Here we are having two pulse generators. We can use any of the pulse generator. So we have connected with P1, and now we will connect the clear to one of the data input switch like this, and now we will connect the output Q0 to first LED like this, and now we will connect output Q1 to second LED like this, and now I will connect Q2 to third LED like this, and now I will connect Q3 to fourth LED like this, and now I have to connect the PR0, PR1, PR2 and PR3, which are presets, so we have to connect it to the input switches. So I have connected PR1 to one of the data input switch, and similarly we have to connect all the presets from 0 to 3 like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now firstly we have to keep all the preset switch positions at high, which is we have to provide logic 1 from the data input switches to the presets PR0, PR1, PR2 and PR3. So we have to provide logic 1 from the data input switches to the preset. So we have to keep them at high position, and we have to keep the clear switch position at 0 initially. And now we will switch on the main unit, and now we have to keep the clear switch at high position, which is 1 like this, and now we have to provide input from the PR0 switch. So we have to keep the PR0 switch to low position. So here on the output LED, which is Q0, we are getting 1 input, and now again we have to keep this PR0 input switch at high, and here we can see still we are getting 1 at the Q0 output. So now we will provide clock and we will see that the state of the Q0, which is currently high, that is 1, so it will change to 0, and the state of Q2 and the state of Q1 will change from 0 to 1. So let's see when we provide the clock. So here you can see that as I have provided clock, so the state of Q0 changes to 0 and the state of Q1 changes to 1. Similarly it will move to Q2, and similarly it will move to Q3. So as you provide the clock, it will proceed like in 4-bit sequence. So here you can see that the LEDs, this is the Q0 output, and now when I provide clock, it moves to Q1. So at Q1 we are getting 1, and now at Q2, and now again at Q3. So similarly, when you provide clock, the output shifts. So this is how 4-bit ring counter works. You can verify the truth table from the manual, and here also you can see when we provide clock, the output behaves like this, and you can cross check the values of output from the truth table and waveform. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this module, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.